So what are cube roots? Now let us see. What we see here is a cube. This figure is cube. The length is equal to 3, the breadth is equal to 3, and the height is equal to 3. If we say that the length is equal to breadth is equal to height is equal to x, can we say that x cube is equal to 27? And what is x cube? Is equal to 3 cube. Then what is x? When we say what is x, we are essentially referring to the cube root of it. It means that we want to find out not an x cube, but the value of x. A cube root would look like this, with 3 sitting here in this bucket. So for example, we would write like this. This would mean, what's the cube root of 27, which means what is x and not x cube. So the answer is 3, of course. X is 3. And what is x? It is 3. So the cube root of 27 can also be represented as 27 raised to 1 by 3. What is 27? 27 is 3 cube. That is raised to 1 by 3. How do you solve this? It is 3 raised to 3 into 1 by 3. This gets cancelled and the answer is 3. So what is cube root of 27? So the answer is 3. So somebody tells you that 15625 is actually a cube number, which means the cube root exists. Okay. If I were to find the cube root of this, one option would be, I would say 15625. I start finding the prime factors. So I would say 5, 5 threes are 15. So what we saw here is the factorization of this is 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5, 5 raised to 6 times. If we were to find the cube root of this, we would say cube root can also be written as 15625 raised to 1 by 3. If the answer is 5 raised to 6 that we found from factorization, it should also be 1 by 3. So the answer is 5 raised to 6 into 1 by 3. So the answer is 5 raised to 3, 2s are 6. And so the answer is 25. So 15625 cube root is 25. So we were referring to cube root of a cube number. Now we saw the method of factorization. There is a shortcut to it. If we know that this is a cube number, the best way is we write this number as 15625. We start from the right hand side. This is the right hand side and this is the left hand side. This is the right hand side. We start from the right hand side. And I move my pen here and say select 3 digits first. 3 is 3. Then select the next 3. If you are not left with 3, then select the 2. Now, let's look at 15 now as a number. Now, what's cube of 2? It's 8. What's cube of 3? It's 27. Does 15 lie between 8 and 7? 27? The answer is yes. So between 2 cube and 3 cube is 15. Whichever is the lower number. So 2 is the lower, 2 cube. So 2 is the lower number. So the first digit of the cube should be equal to 2. I'll take one more example for simplicity. Let me explain this. Let's look at 625 now. If 625, which means whichever is the number that can make it as a cube, should end in 5, always remember, 2 cube will end in 8, 3 cube will end in 27, so it will end in 7, 4 cube will end in 64, it will end in 4, 5 cube will end in 125. So 5 cube will always end in 5. So which means if there is a number ending in 5, whichever is a number which is making this whole number a cube should end in 5, and hence I take 25. So if you cube 25, you will find the answer as 15625. Let me take one more example. Let's go from the right hand side, select 3 numbers, wait, and then select 3 numbers, but we don't have, so we'll select 2 numbers. Let's talk about 17 now. We can do prime factorization here. I don't want to do it. I know that this is a cube number. Let me figure out. Now, 2 cube is equal to 8. 3 cube is equal to 27. We know that 17 lies between 8 and 27. So we know that the number, the cube root of this, this is a cube number. The cube root, the first digit of this has to be the lower one of these. So the first digit is 2. Now which is the second digit? So that we eventually, when we cube, we get the answer as 17576. Let us find the second digit. Now second digit comes from 576. When you find the cubes of a number, 1 cube is equal to 1, 2 cube is equal to, okay, what we see from the set here is the only number which ends in 6 has the cube of 6, which means if this is ending in 6, the second number has to be 6 here. If it were ending in 5, we knew that the number that can take here is 5. So it's 26. So 26 cube will effectively give you 17576.